Now, let's dive into an important part of our UX process, creating user personas. These will help us see the common patterns across current and potential Greenleaf Grocers customers, and provide an anchor for the design decisions we make in our product. In a more realistic project setting, we might share these with our client to make sure we've accurately captured the qualities of who we're designing for. To start, open back up your Greenleaf Grocers project folder and head to the design file, Project Workspace. You can use the page titled Start Here or tap on the plus button to create a new one. We're going to create a few cards, each representing a different persona we can reference later on. To do this, let's create a template we can duplicate. Using the frame tool or shortcut F, create a frame for your template. You can choose any size, but I'll start with size A4. You can rename this layer a few different ways. The first being double tapping its title in the layers list. If there's a floating title, you can also double tap that. But the easiest way I've found is selecting that layer and hitting Command R or Control R for Windows. Let's call this Persona Template. Since personas tend to have repeating elements, like a title and text combo, let's start by creating a component where we'll capture attributes for each of our personas. Create a text layer with shortcut T and add some placeholder text. Make a copy by holding Option while you drag on Mac or Control while you drag on Windows and replace the placeholder text. Now, select both and put them into an auto layout by using shortcut Shift A. It's ready to be turned into a component. With the layer selected, head to the component icon on your properties panel. Any styling changes we make to this master component will get passed down to all of our copies. So I'm going to move this outside of my frame, just so it's easier to edit and out of the way, and I'll make 5 copies inside for the attributes I want to capture. Again, using that shortcut of holding Option while I drag on Mac and Control while I drag on Windows. And those 5 attributes are name, demographics, goals, pain points, and motivations. Adding all of these to an auto layout will help us create uniform spacing in between all 5 elements. Select everything and again use shortcut Shift A. We can adjust the spacing as needed in our properties panel. I'll also rename this new frame using shortcut Command R or Control R for Windows. Since we might want to share these personas more widely, let's take a pass at making them feel more visually aligned with the Greenleaf Grocers brand. On the Assets, Colors, and Type page, you can find things like their logo and icons. Let's copy some of these over and make some new styling adjustments. You can access text styles with this icon next to the typography panel. As well as color styles by tapping on the same icon next to the fill title. If you don't want to use this style anymore, you can tap on the unlink icon, where then I can start to change the color more freely. Let's also create a frame to add a photo of our persona. We have a few images you can use in the Project Resources folder, and you'll be able to change these once we turn this into a component too. Using the frame tool with shortcut F, click and drag while you hold the Shift key to create a square shape. Head to your Properties panel and go down to Fill. Tap on the plus button, and then on the color swatch. Up at the top, tap on the icon that looks like an image, and then tap on Upload from Computer. I'll also make some styling adjustments to make sure this looks right. Once everything looks good, let's turn this whole frame into a component like we did earlier and make 2 copies to start. So I'll select the frame and go to the component icon on the top right. And then I'll just make two copies. These will be the ones that I edit and share. And this one will be the one that I use to make any styling changes. Now, it's time to do some synthesis. Refer to your Greenleaf Grocers creative brief and spend some time looking across patterns and themes. These personas should give you a broad snapshot of the customers you're designing for. And while they're fictional creations, they should be connected to the real people behind them. I'm going to start one for a younger, single, tech-savvy customer I'll call Eco-Conscious Emma. It looks like I'll need to make some adjustments to make sure this text fills the space better. Be sure to go to your master copy on the left and make your edits there. And I'm just going to increase the size of this placeholder text so it stands out a little bit more. Now, I'll follow these steps again to create a different persona. Awesome work! You've created flexible templates for you to map out the types of customers who will guide your design decisions. This living document will serve as a compass on our design journey with Greenleaf Grocers. Feel free to continue building on this and give your personas even more depth and personality.